These days, it's kind of tricky for smartphones to really truly stand out against their peers, but Oppo is one manufacturer that's doing a pretty damn good job of swinging its junk about. Recently, of course, we reviewed the Find X with its highly enjoyable pop-up camera, and now we've got the Oppo RX17 Pro, which has got all kinds of funky bits, including a tri-lens camera, dual batteries, an in-screen fingerprint sensor, and all kinds of other sexy shenanigans. I've been using the RX17 Pro as my full-time personal handset for a week now, and here is my in-depth review. And don't forget, for more reviews, the latest and greatest mobile tech, to poke, subscribe, and ding that notifications bell. Cheers. So one area where modern smartphones are really struggling to stand out from the crowd is the design. Skinny bezels, massive screens, they're all basically clones of one another, and Oppo's blower definitely sticks to that blueprint. That said, I do like the two different colours on offer, including this subtle turquoisey green model. The RX17 Pro's glass surface is apparently inspired by light and water, while the refined texture rests like satin on your palm. And whichever soulless marketing hack came up with those little gems deserves a precision-delivered flurry of rapid foot motions to their soft and vulnerable nether regions. But all marketing bollocks aside, the glossy rear really does catch the light in a very alluring fashion, morphing from black to dark blue to green as you twist it about the place. That moody finish does a bang-up job of hiding scuffs and greasy prints too, while the curved finish gives it a nice and comfortable grip. There's no water resistance on offer, but the RX17 Pro still seems pretty rugged. I've carried it about in my pocket with other phones, and that shiny surface is yet to be scratched. Meanwhile, the front panel is constructed from the latest Gorilla Glass 6, and that is buried underneath a pre-installed screen protector. Kinda like encasing Jason Statham in a bunch of concrete. And then if you factor in the bonus phone cover that you get bundled in the box, the Oppo RX17 Pro is essentially better protected than the flippin' queen. Oppo's 6.2-inch AMOLED screen is just as pleasing to the eye as rivals like the OnePlus 6T's panel. It's bright, it's punchy, and that Full HD Plus resolution keeps visuals crisp. Frankly, it is rare to find a disappointing display these days, so that's no real surprise. Customization options are rather limited, but you do get the usual blue light filters and such forth. And as for the audio, yeah, there's no 3.5mm headphone jack. But while there's no dongle in the box, you do at least get a pair of bundled USB phones. As for the software on board, it's a love and tangle of ColorOS 5.2 and Android Oreo. No word yet on when the Pi update is coming, but we're hoping early 2019. You can get a full overview of ColorOS in my Oppo F9 and Oppo Find X tips and tricks guide, but the quick version is that you get quite a few bonus features thrown on top of Android, including proper facial recognition that works rather well. That's in addition to the fingerprint sensor, which, like the OnePlus 6T and the Mate 20 Pro, is built into the display itself. This also works a charm for the most part, whether you press light or hard, although only when your digits aren't sticky or mucky. Of course, like other in-display fingerprint sensors, it does occasionally fail, especially as it's having to work through that screen protector, but for the most part, it does a bang-up job. ColorOS also adds some gesture controls like Huawei and OnePlus, although there's no proper swipey navigation like what you get with Android Pie and most other rival mobiles these days. Other features feel rather familiar too. The Smart Assistant is like a stripped-back version of OxygenOS's shell feature, while you get parental controls in the form of Kid Space and gaming assistance through the GameSpace app. These generally do their assigned jobs without any grumble, but unfortunately, ColorOS also has its fair share of quirks, including some very iPhone ways of doing things. The complete lack of an app store for one is really bloody annoying. Performance is sadly not the Oppo RX17 Pro's strong suit either. While most of the rivals at this price point, like the OnePlus 6T, have Qualcomm Snapdragon 845 chipset banged inside, the Oppo RX17 Pro makes do with a Snapdragon 710 instead, although at least it is backed by 6 gigs of RAM. Everyday running is fine, although you will see the occasional stammer and stutter when flipping between apps. Not exactly marvellous, considering this isn't a budget blower. Still, you can play games like PUBG with respectable detail levels and a pretty consistent frame rate, whether you're using that game space feature or not. But if you are going to be doing a lot of gaming, we definitely have to point you elsewhere instead, as you get better value for money. One of the more intriguing aspects of the RX17 Pro's design is the dual battery arrangement. Rather than getting just a single 3,700mAh cell, you get dual 1,350mAh batteries that work in tandem. The reason for this is faster charging. Using Oppo's Super VOOC tech, the RX17 Pro can power back up insanely fast as both batteries are filled simultaneously. With the phone switched off, a full charge finishes in just under 40 minutes. Definitely a record as far as we're concerned. As for the battery drain, well, that's pretty bloody good too. Even when I'm constantly piddling about on the Pro, I always finish the day with a good chunk of change. And if you don't hammer the phone with games or long Skype sessions, you should easily manage 2 days of use before the phone needs another charge. Also intriguing is that tri-lens camera tech. Although sadly, right now at the time of filming, one of those lenses is about as much use as a codpiece in a nunnery. That primary shooter is a 12 megapixel f/8 with adjustable aperture. This can flip between f1.5 and f2.4 automatically to suit any given lighting conditions. It's backed by a 20 megapixel secondary lens, while there's also a third time of flight camera lens which can accurately measure the distance between the Oppo RX17 Pro and any object held within its sights. This will apparently allow users to capture an accurate 3D recreation of any object. At least it will do once Oppo actually gets around to adding the ToF feature to the phone. We've asked the manufacturer about when to expect this, and Oppo itself reckons this will come early 2019, so stay tuned for our in-depth review of that feature when it actually hits. Right now, those other two lenses do a pretty decent job of capturing photos and video. With workable lighting conditions and a still subject or scene, the RX17 Pro produces detailed snaps with natural looking colours. More tricky lighting is also dealt with in a respectable fashion. HDR shots are generally well balanced, and in low light, that changeable aperture means quite crisp, bright results. There is a night mode on offer too, which does help out a little bit with clarity. Those contours and edges are more clearly defined, although the grain count is occasionally also upped. There's also an AI scene recognition feature, just like on Huawei's phones, although on the RX17 Pro, this seems to make absolutely bugger all difference in the majority of cases. Where this handset sadly falls down for photo quality is with moving subjects. Even in fairly well lit environments, any motion often results in blurry results, so if you have kids, prepare to chuck away a lot of your shots. As for the video, the 4K resolution results appear more punchy and vibrant than the full HD video that we shot on the same phone, but in both cases the lenses react well to changes in lighting and focus, while the effective image stabilization keeps jitters to a minimum, even at that Ultra HD level, and the directional audio pickup is also solid. So in conclusion, the Oppo RX17 Pro is definitely a tempting and quite original proposition. At this price point, the OnePlus 6T does unfortunately offer stronger performance, but the RX17 Pro certainly impresses when it comes to that battery tech. It's just a shame that ColorOS isn't quite as lovable as the excellent Oxygen OS. So now over to you. Are you tempted by Oppo's RX17 Pro? Definitely be great to hear your thoughts down below, and if not, why not? What would you be tempted by instead? As I say, stay tuned for more in-depth reviews of the latest and greatest mobile tech. We've got a few coming up in January 2019 already. Hooray! For more on all of that shenanigans, don't forget to poke, subscribe, and ding that notifications bell, and have yourselves a lovely day. Cheers.